What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here for a reading of the Bitcoin Optech Group newsletter. Thank you very much to all the principals and associates, as well as the founding sponsors of this great open source organization. Today, newsletter number 54, on July 10th, 2019. This week's newsletter announces the release of the newest version of Eclair and describes a potential routing improvement for Lightning Network. Also included are our regular sections about BEC32 sending support and notable code changes in popular Bitcoin infrastructure projects. Action items, none this week. News, Eclair version 0.3.1 is released. The newest version of this Lightning Network software includes new and improved API calls, as well as other changes that allow it to perform faster and use less memory. Upgrading is recommended. JackGPG signatures. Brainstorming, just-in-time routing, and free channel rebalancing. Some Lightning Network node receive a routed payment that they reject because their outbound channel for that payment does not currently have a high enough balance to support it. René Picard previously posted just-in-time JIT routing, where the node would attempt to move funds into that channel from one or more of its other channel balances. If successful, the payment could then be routed. Otherwise, it would be rejected, like normal. Because the routed payment might fail for other reasons and prevent the routing node from earning any fee, any JIT rebalance operation need to be free, or they could end up costing the node money in a way that an attacker could exploit. In a new post to the Lightning Death mailing list, the pseudonymous Lightning Network developer Z-Man describes two situations in which other profit-maximizing nodes might allow free rebalancing. The first case is the observation that the next hop in the route will receive its own routing fee paid by the sender, if the payment succeeds. Z-Man describes a method by which the next hop's node can make their part of the rebalancing contingent on the receipt of the routing income, ensuring that they either get paid or that the rebalancing does not happen. This would require additional communication between nodes, and so it is a change that probably needs further discussion in order to be considered for addition to the Lightning Network specification. The second case Z-Man provides is other nodes along the rebalance path who themselves want to rebalance one or more of their channels in that same direction as the routing node. These nodes can allow free routing in that direction to encourage someone to perform that rebalancing. This second case does not require any changes to the Lightning Network specification. Nodes can already set their routing fees to zero, allowing any other nodes to attempt just-in-time routing with free rebalances. The worst case would be a payment that would have failed anyway, will take a bit longer to return a failure message to the spender. A delay equal to the amount of time any routing node spends attempting to rebalance their channels in order to support that payment. BEC32 sending support in week 17 of 24 of the series about allowing the people you pay to access all of SegWit's multiple benefits. As we have shown in earlier parts of the series, BEC32 addresses are better in almost every way than legacy addresses. They allow users to save fees. They are easier to transcribe. They address typos, can be located, and they are more efficient in QR codes. However, as there is one feature that legacy pay-to-public key hash addresses support that is not widely supported by native SegWit wallets, message signing support. In the spirit of full disclosure and the hopes of spurring wallet developers into action, we will take a look at this missing piece of BEC32 address support. For background, many wallets allow the user with a legacy pay-to-public key hash address to sign an arbitrary text message using the private key, ultimately associated with that address. For example, in the Bitcoin command line interface, get raw address of the legacy, and then sign message of that address with the message test. Unfortunately, there is no widely implemented method for creating and signing messages with legacy pay-to-script hash, pay-to-script hash Reft Segwit or native Segwit addresses. In Bitcoin Core and many other wallets, trying to use anything besides a legacy pay-to-public key hash address will fail. For example, with this VEC32 address, to sign the message test, we get error code -3, the address does not refer to a key. Some wallets do support message signing for SegWit addresses, but in a non-standardized way. For example, the Trezor and Electrum wallets each provide message signing support for pay-to-witness public key hash and pay-to-script hash wrapped pay-to-witness public key hash addresses. Yet, both implementations were made independently and use slightly different protocols so that they are unable to verify signatures produced by the other system. Additionally, the algorithm used by wallets we are aware of cannot be easily adopted to pay-to-script hash and pay-to-witness script hash scripts used for multisig and other advanced encumbrances. That means message signing today is universally limited to users of single sig addresses. There is a proposed standard that should allow any address type or script to be used to create a signed message. That is BIP-322. The protocol should even be forward compatible with future SegWit versions such as BIP-Taproot and BIP-TapScript, with some unresolved limitations related to time locks. Unfortunately, even though the proposal was first made more than 1 year ago, see newsletter number 13, there is no implementation for it, not even a proposed implementation under review. This leaves users of SegWit without the same level of message signing support available to users of legacy addresses, and it may represent a reason some users are unwilling to move to SegWit addresses. The only solution, besides wallet abandoning message signing support, are for wallet developers to agree on a standard and then widely implement it. Notable code and documentation changes this week in Bitcoin Core, LND, C-Lightning, Eclair, LibSecP256K1, and the Bitcoin Improvement Proposals. This Bitcoin Core change extends the UTXO update PSBT RPC with a descriptors parameter that takes an output script descriptor and uses it to update a BIP-174 partially signed Bitcoin transaction with information about the scripts, addresses involved in that transaction. This is in addition to the RPC's previous behavior of adding information to the PSBT from the nodes mempool and UTXO set. This new feature is especially useful for hardware wallets and other paired wallets, as it makes it possible to add hierarchical deterministic key path information to the PSBT so that wallets asked to sign a PSBT can easily derive the keys needed for signing or verify that a change output does indeed pay back into the wallet. This Bitcoin Core change aborts adding funds to an unsigned transaction if its fee rate is above the maximum amount set by the max transaction fee confirmation option. The default is 0.1 Bitcoin. Previously, the funding code would silently reduce the fee to the maximum, which could lead to users with typos in their transaction overpaying as much as $1,200 in fee at current prices. The new behavior gives users a chance to fix typos and eliminates any loss of funds. This Eclair change adds support for tag length value message encoding. Lightning Network implementation plans to move most of their messages to this format in the future. LND and C-Lightning have previously implemented TLV support. Peers, you gotta subscribe to the Bitcoin OpTech newsletter. Thank you very much again to the founding sponsors, the principals, and the associates of this great open source organization. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. Thank you very much to all your contributions on the Telecoin, and see you on the next week. Bye-bye.